Hey, what's going on, guys? Welcome back to 3FG, another episode of Let's Play Destiny. Right here, we're on the Scourge of Winter. I can read. Hunt and kill Draxus, the House of Winter's Kel, hiding deep in the caves of the Ishtar Sink. Awesome, guys. My name is MechSamus. Thank you so much for joining in. As you'll notice here, I'm level 25. What the heck? In the last episode, you were just level 12 or 19 or something like that. But we actually had some technical difficulties in the previous recording again, and so now I'm recording at a later time. Let's jump in. 3, 2, 1, boop. Awesome. Let's do this. Very, very excited about this. Oh, yeah.
Those fallen we faced in the archive belong to the House of Winter. Their Kel, Draxus, has been hunted by guardians for years. If these reports are correct, he's commanding them from a network of caves up in the cinders. If we want to keep the Academy's secret safe, we should push into their lair and take him out.
So I can't wait to... I have to admit, Venus is by far my favorite planet in terms of just the look and feel. It's just so gorgeous. All
I'm ready if you are.
So right now, currently, what's going on in the world of Destiny as I'm recording this is the Queen's Wrath missions. You'll notice I got the purple robe going, the Queen's robe. It's pretty wicked awesome. And also got a new sniper rifle. Just got my first exotic helmet. Shazam! 360. Oh, that was a terrible 360. Get out of here. But yeah, we got some wicked awesome equipment, so you guys will be able to see some high-level equipment and what you're in store for. If you're still on the fence about getting Destiny, or you're just simply not there yet. So, look at these guys. They have the Queen's Robe as well. Hey, what's up, Queen's Robe people? How you doing?
That's got to be the way into their lair.
Just give me my helping hand. Headshot. Glimmer. This. I'm going to show you guys my sweet purple and gold sniper rifle. It's so glorious. Ooh. I don't remember these crystals being here. Those things are nice. Hey, look at us all with our queen's robes.
There could be thousands of fallen
hello.
In here.
Hello. Goodbye. Thousands of fallen? Really? Holy crap. And thousands of headshots there shall be. Hello, Dreg. Hello. Goodbye. Oh, 3,000. 3,500 damage for a critical hit. Oh my goodness. That was ridiculous. I don't think I've ever seen a critical hit that much before. Dang. Wow. That is awesome. So yeah, we have to go in here, we have to kill some of these guards that are protecting this big old fallen guy. And we gotta go kill the big old fallen guy. Yep. So, really cool things that I've unlocked is the Sunsinger's newest melee damage ability is when your melee is fully charged up, the person you punch basically...
The Kel's guard is here.
Goodbye. The person just explodes and do a whole bunch of things. Now, I know in a previous video, I think there was a re-record on Moon. And I was super beefy then. I think I had a different type of grenade. At the end of the day... Ooh, no parlay.
Kel must be close.
At the end of the day, I really came to the conclusion that the original grenade that just kind of sits there, it burns them, and does damage over time. If anyone walks into it, they get burned and stuff. That just kind of became the overall much better approach. Oh, I love it. Much better approach to... grenades. You know, I know there's the one that splits off into multiple things, and there's the one that's like a sticky grenade and stuff, but it just really didn't fit every scenario like the original grenade does, and so there's a lot more utility to that, and so that's why I kind of went back to that grenade. Now, a really cool thing I unlocked with Radiance, which you guys saw in the previous episode, that just makes you go Super Saiyan as a Warlock, is that now if I die and I have a supercharge, I can actually revive myself by entering Radiance mode. And not only do I revive myself, but I come back as a crazy Super Saiyan.
A catch.
So it is
it must
pretty
belong
wicked
to
awesome.
The House of Winter.
There's a guy.
I've never
there.
Seen one on the surface.
What? Ow!
The Kell's gotta
what the
be
heck?
Inside.
The Kell's gotta be in there. Let's take him out. I know, pop it. Oh my gosh. Oh, 3,500. Nasty. Let's take it out. Boom. Good night. Good night. Hello, Vandal. Goodbye, Vandal. And hello, Vandal. Good night. Boom. Headshot. Alright. There's one guy right here. Vandal's like, what's going on? Oh! Him. Oh my gosh, I got another bounty. Extermination protocol. I think that's get 500 headshots on Vandals. Oh, I mean, on the Fallen. Which was I've been working on forever. Oh, I'm glad that happened. Ooh, let's get this happen. Oh my gosh, through the shields and all. Through the fire and flames. Oh, that song is so hard to beat Power Hero. I never beat it on expert. Like, everyone wanted me to. But I did try my hand at that hard mode. Didn't beat it on the hard mode either. Just, I could be really good on the mode. But I digress. There's some fun instead of talking. Here. These guys, and then we're going to enter in onto the spacecraft that is holding... I already forgot his name. Really unique name. I'm so bad at it. So I still got my supercharge. I'm gonna kind of save that for the final mission. Another cool thing that Radiance does that not a lot of people talk about is the cooldown for grenades increases dramatically. And I stress the word dramatically because you can practically throw a grenade every 2 to 3 seconds. In radius mode, so as soon as you activate it, if you start throwing grenades immediately, you can probably throw off about 5 to 6 grenades very, very quickly. Another cool thing is that I'll show you guys the location of the gold chest. Gold chest is located right up here on the orbit spaceship. It's not there in this video because I've never gotten it. Got all the gold chests in the game. This guy in the background wants to shoot me. This guy. Oh, trust me, sir. You'll have your day. Oh, really? Now you disappeared? You saw me bust out? Wait. Oh, jeez. Oh, no! You made me miss? Oh, there's two of them! Jeez. Alright, dang. That always bumps me right in the ass. Especially with AI characters, it's like, oh man, I should have got that. I should have got that. Look at me! Slide. This gun is just absolutely ridiculous. You know, I wouldn't always recommend the fast shooting assault rifles. I know that they're very tempting to choose, but the low damage impact is a sacrifice. It's a very large sacrifice.
Somewhere
in
this thing, there's a throne room. That's where we'll find Draxus.
Draxus is his name. That's right. It's a large sacrifice that really balances out. The assault rifle is making it so this assault rifle doesn't just dominate something else. Now, I do know it's really handy-dandy notebook in PvE, but in PvP, that is where you have to be very, very well diversed in this type of weapon. If you come into a firefight late or anything like that, then very, very hard to not that successful because it does so little chip damage. Every bullet you miss is one step closer to your death, so it's very different. It's very unique. Assault rifle. Some people prefer the slower shooting assault rifle because it just does way more damage output and it's much easier to control. The reason I'm using this, and even sometimes I don't like using it, is because it's a legendary. I don't have any other legendary primary weapon as of yet. And I also really want to rank this battle to see what it can do. So I'm very, very excited about it. Goodbye, Kel'god. Goodbye, Kel'god. Oh, come on. You should have exploded. Come on, give me that lunge. That's one of the things that I've actually become very... That's slowly becoming one of my favorite things is melee. I love it so much. Especially when you get in that sweet spot where your character lunges forward, similar to when he had the energy sword in Halo 2. Oh, it's just amazing. Hello, Draxus.
There's the cow!
So, you guys, I know you want to see it. Here we go. 3, 2, 1. Super Saiyan mode. Oh, wow. The camera angle. We got another grenade. Oh, man. Another grenade. There it is. Goodbye. Draxus. Crossbows are ours.
Draxus was one of the worst plagues this system has ever seen. Without their kill, houses usually turn against each other. We may finally have broken their hold on the Academy.
This is my throne. My land. We have claimed it to be 3FG's land. Okay. Alright. Wow, two bounties. I can't believe that. That is awesome. Alright, so obviously we get no rewards because we've already done this single player mission already. But yeah, so that is the Scourge's Winter, Venus mission number 4. If you guys enjoyed the video, please hit the like button. Also subscribe if you haven't already. And be sure if you want to support the channel directly to share this on your favorite social networks. We are in all of them. Tumblr, Google+, Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, Pinterest as well. For all you pinners or Pinteresters or... Okay, I'm gonna stop talking. Anyway, guys, thank you so much for joining. I'll see you guys in the next video. MechSamus, signing off.